We have two more delegate speakers, and I would like to call Nitish Bharadwaj from Hyderabad. He will speak in English. Nitish.
Param Pooja Swamiji's present here, distinguished guests on the dais, and my dear friends. Today we are recollecting those reminiscences of that same person who was born in this very bylanes of Calcutta, and how he moved the world with his message of strength and fearlessness. I would like to share with you a very small incident which happened in a very small city called as Vijayawada in Andhra Pradesh. In the government hospital of Vijayawada, a woman aged around 70 years was lying abandoned on the stairs of the government hospital because there was no attendant. And when we had taken this woman and when we admitted her into the hospital, the doctors diagnosed that she was suffering from a very final stage of cancer and her days are numbered. Next day, we went and we had inquired about the health of this woman. She told us, "I have nobody. I have no husband. I have no son. I have no daughter. My husband used to beat me every day in the evening because he was drunk. There was no money in the house. He used to beat me every day in the evening. And later he died of liver cirrhosis. My son followed the same footsteps of his father. He used to drink every day and he just abandoned her. Later it was known that he also died. There is no money, there is no possession. And this happened, I think, according to what she told me, it happened around 30 years back during the great cyclone of 1970, when the whole area was devastated. And I asked her, "Amma, what is it that which is giving you strength to fight this? And can you imagine, my dear young brothers and sisters who are present here, can you imagine what she told? An ordinary, illiterate, uneducated, so-called villager told me that, Babu, this world will, we are fishermen, hum machli pakadne wale hain. This world will offer us baits, just like we put baits to fish. And we are entangled in the net. And suddenly, all these obstacles come and we are nowhere. And the most interesting part is, she heard this statement from one of the Swamis of Ramakrishna Sangha who went as a relief program in 1970 cyclone. Can you imagine? This is Bharat. This is the Sanskriti of our country. We all appreciate Swamiji. We say, very boldly, in Swamiji, everything is positive and nothing negative. But where are those men and women who can apply Swamiji in our day-to-day lives? We are so good in clapping. We are so good in applause. We just came here. We think we have come for a pilgrimage. We'll take a few photographs. We'll eat the prasadam and we go back. But what am I doing with my body and mind? What am I doing with my resources? What am I doing with my education? What am I doing with my skills so that I can build my own country? What I can do to my own people? That's what Swamiji expected. Swamiji said in one position, when he was tired of this name and fame, he said, "I don't want to be called as a cyclonic monk. I want to create those giants who will take my work. Fired with the zeal of holiness, not ordinary pygmies." My dear friends, the task is very huge. Today we are so fortunate that we have come here to celebrate the 150th birth anniversary of Swamiji, which is coinciding with the golden moment in the history of the world where more than 60% of Indian population is young blood. It is such an opportunity, but if we do not rise, if we do not increase our potential, if we do not bring our skills to the benefit of our people, to the benefit of our country, the same demographic dividend will turn into a demographic tragedy. We need opportunities. We need to bring our own skills. We need to bridge our own skills. We need to be We need to manufacture more and more entrepreneurs in ourselves. We need to get more and more exposure from the West. Swamiji used to say, we need to learn the power of organization from the West, and we need to give our spiritual pearls to them. That's why he inspired Jamshedji Nusarwanji Tata to start an institute. That's why he inspired Sister Nivedita to educate women, to bring an awareness in women. That's why he inspired so many kings in his very short lifespan to see that the Indian population gets their right own individuality. The task is huge. It is we have to decide whether we'll be spectators to this wonderful moment in the history of India, or whether we will truly decide to participate in this. So the task is huge, and we have so much to do with our own resources, with our own skills, and with our own education, with our own possibilities in our own country, in our own sphere of development. I thank Swami Sarvapriyananji Maharaj for giving me this opportunity, and especially Hyderabad Math for asking me to come here, and all my friends for patiently listening. Namaste, Jai Hind.
Thank you, Nitish. Thank you for your inspiring words.